Please let's welcome our honoree for our 25th anniversary, George Tsunis.
Trying to call a contractor now to open up a bigger door so my head can get through it. I am deeply honored and humbled to be recognized by the LGBT network this evening. Doubly so to be here with my friend and mentor, Congressman Steve Israel. Steve, you've always been a tireless advocate for social equity, and I love you. I love you. You're a great friend. Thank you. Like Dr. Martin Luther King, all of us share a dream. A dream that soon we will live in a world where a person's sexual orientation or gender identity will be as controversial as the length of one's hair or the color of one's eyes. A world that condemns any attempt to discriminate our differences. That has been the vision of the LGBT network for 25 impactful and transformative years. Growing up a first generation child of Greek-speaking immigrants, I always felt a little different than most of my assimilated schoolmates. But my sisters and I shared a priceless gift, that of unconditional love. Through this love, my parents taught me to be proud of what made me different, my immigrant roots, and to embrace the difference in other people. Through this love came acceptance of myself and others. So I know firsthand that children who feel accepted and loved for who they are at home and by their peers are much more likely to become emotionally healthy adults. From love comes not only comfort, but empathy, a genuine ability to be caring and kind. This is the cycle we must perpetuate. This is what the LGBT network does for young people and adults alike. Many of us know that navigating through teenage years is difficult under the best of circumstances. Physical and emotional changes can cause them to be extremely self-conscious and extremely self-critical. LGBT teens who may be struggling with their own identity are especially vulnerable. As we so sadly know, they are often the objects of bullying, threats, and even hatred. In today's world, those difficulties are compounded because of social media, where one hurtful remark can be magnified a thousandfold. It is vital for communities to support organizations which provide a safe place for LGBT young people and adults, a nurturing place where they feel valued and accepted. The network provides precisely this type of environment. David Kelnick and the LGBT network, we owe you a tremendous debt of gratitude. David, I'm not quite sure what grade you got on your project 24 years today, but buddy, A plus. Before you started on your journey, on behalf of one of the great human rights battles of our time, I've often said this is my generation's Selma, Alabama moment. These programs, this empathy, this insight, much less this popular support, we have a room full of elected officials here supporting us, simply did not exist. Thank you, David, and thank you, Robert, your partner on this journey, for making us all better people. John F. Kennedy taught us to be blind to our differences, but to direct our attention to our common interests, at least we can make the world safe for diversity. We are not there yet, but I am hopeful the world is well on its way to becoming one of inclusion, where diversity is celebrated and embraced, and where bullying and intolerance are dashed. To me, America is an aspiration, a perpetual search for the Founding Fathers' more perfect union, an effort to breathe life in our foundational principle of E pluribus unum, out of many, one. One. Now, sometimes success can only be measured in the appreciation of small steps, but we can never be complacent. As Dr. King says, we must continue to bend the arc of the moral universe ever closer to justice. Because the need exists, the work continues, and the struggle endures, we must continue to accept and honor the challenge of Dr. King's dream to achieve a just world. So that one day, at a future LGBT gala, we will gather to celebrate that realized dream of social inclusiveness and acceptance. Instead of exhorting a ballroom full of determined advocates and agents of social justice. Until then, let us commit to work tirelessly together for all those who still live afraid to love who they love, to be who they are, and to be accepted everywhere. This is still one of the moral imperatives of our time, and it is up to all of us to fight for it. From the bottom of my heart, thank you very much.